welcome back to Bova Space. Hope you all are doing good. In my previous video of utility area organization, I had showed my open pantry and I got a few requests on how one can organize it to make it look neat and tidy even if it isn't closed. I mean, obviously it's an open pantry. Now friends, let me share with you some of the ideas that I use to keep my pantry organized. You have already seen my previous video of my home back in Bangalore. It was a closed pantry, it was more of a tall unit, and I had showed you the ways in which I kept it organized. Open pantry is always a very tricky area because you can't really rough handle things and just push things in it. That's exactly how it starts looking messy, and it really spoils the aesthetics of any kitchen. This video, I bet, will really help you. Also, there are some kitchens which are open and they do not have any cabinets. So I hope this video comes handy to some of you all who are having an open kitchen concept. Now please do share some of your ideas also. It might just help me in my pantry. And if you really like some of these tips and if you have applied it, please do not forget to put it in the comments section below. The links to some of the products that I have used, I have put it in the description box. So friends, without much delay, let's get started. Please do not forget to subscribe to my channel and like the video and share it. This video will be very useful if you have a traditional setup or if you do bulk purchases and want to keep it simple and easy. To begin with, I use modular storage containers because of their large capacity and the fact that I can store more in a very less space, as you can see it here. Now, one of the best and easiest ways to make an open pantry look organized is to label them. Unless you're really careless, I can bet that labeling will never ever let your pantry mess up crazily. Moving on to the spice rack, all of the spices are lined up on a tiered shelf for easy visibility and quick access. I use glass jars for storing spices and written names on the lids. Might want to reuse coffee bottles or jam bottles as they are generally very sturdy and are made to retain freshness. Now in this shelf I have used lazy Susans for storing specific set of items in each one of them. This one, for instance, has things like pickles, ghee and honey, which are oily, greasy or may end up leaking and spoil the rest of the things around it. These bins have quick fix snacks for my kids' short eats at school. In this shelf, the different baskets contain extra stock of groceries. These groceries are sorted based on the needs and specific use of each item. This one contains unused portions of snacks in Ziploc bags. This basket mostly contains all ready-to-eat items that come handy, especially when I am unwell. And this one has all ingredients required to make some pasta. It comes handy to prepare when I have guests coming over with kids. Now I have used this area to store Ziploc bags and tissues handy. Not the least, I have used the floor space to keep rice and atta containers. Onion and potato stock is also here, separated into two baskets on a shelf organizer. Next to the pantry, I have kept a few shopping checklists handy
and along with them is a sheet of labels for quick use. So friends, I hope you found my open pantry organization ideas useful. Please don't forget to download the grocery shopping checklist from the links in the description box or directly from Bovis Spaces website. Thanks again for watching, and until the next time, stay organized, stay productive, and stay happy. Bye-bye.